So this is a flight into Hangzhou Airport in China. It was in the middle of the night. Everybody's tired, and a few things happened here which are quite interesting. So let's have a look. So let's look at the situation. We are passing 9,000 feet. Oh, actually, they're using meters here, so I should say clear to 2,400 meters, and currently passing 2,800 meters. And we are slowing down to green knot speed, it looks like it, and at 35 miles. So let's do a profile calculation. So 30 miles times 3 is 9,000 feet. And let's take green knot speed for the reference. Actually, we're closer to 250, but we're slowing down, so let's take green knot speed. So we should be at 8,000 feet. And 5 miles, so that's 1,500 feet, so that's 9,500 feet. So we should be at 9,500 feet here. And we are at 9,000 feet, but also a little bit above green dot speed. So it looks like we're good. So far, so good. Okay, so let's skip ahead. And now, next altitude calculation will be at 30 miles. So 30 times 3 is 9,000 feet. Now we're definitely at green dot speed. So we should be at 8,000 feet when we are at 30 miles. Okay, so we're now at 32 miles. So let's do a proper calculation here. At 30 miles, now we are at 8,400 feet, so that looks a bit high. Now let me backtrack a little bit because a few things go wrong here. Okay, so if you look at the navigation display, you can see here that there's a speed restriction at this waypoint of 205 knots. Now let's see what the first officer does. So he selects flap 1 and then sets 205 knots, because if I go back a little bit, so 205 knots, that's actually below green knot speed. Now the problem here is though that okay, we're slowing down to 205 knots, that's good, but the thing is, these speeds, they are always maximum speeds, not minimum speeds or edge speeds. It's always a maximum. So as long as you're slower than 205 knots, that's fine. You can't see that on the display, but you can see that on the chart. It will say maximum. So selecting a speed here of 205 knots, that does not necessarily make sense. You will have to check your profile to see if you can do that or not. So as we just calculated, at 30 miles you want to be at 8,000 feet with this speed anyway. So it looks like we're a little bit below, a little bit above profile here, and especially if we're going to fly level, because we're approaching our cleared altitude here. Then, okay, so here's an altitude bug. If you are on profile or above profile and you need to descend but you can't, you need to slow down. If you don't, the aircraft will add power and that will make the situation worse. Okay, so here's 30 miles. So we're definitely a little bit too high, and it's gonna level off. It has to because of the altitude restriction. So there's alt constraint star, and soon the aircraft will start to add power because the speed is selected. There you go. There goes the power, and now we're getting high on profile. So instead, we should just manage the speed here to allow the thrust to remain at idle. But that's not done. So now, even more interesting what ha will happen next. So if I skip ahead a little bit, so here we pass the altitude constraint, and so now we can start to descend. So we go to descent mode. Okay, the aircraft says more drag. That's just a clue. That's not always correct, but in this case, it is correct. And let's see what happens next. So we go to open descent, okay, and this flap 1 is still selected. We had the speed bug still selected there, okay, fine. But before we already calculated we were high on profile, so now the only way to fix that is not with a higher speed like it's done here. The speed is still set higher, or perhaps that was because of a misunderstanding of the speed restriction. But regardless, the only way to fix a high energy situation where when you're very close, or less than 80 miles really to the airport, is using drag, which is the speed brake in this case. Okay, so now the speed is managed, and which it's a little bit too early perhaps, because usually you do that at about 15 miles where you start to slow down from green dot to S speed. But okay, now of course if you manage the speed now, the aircraft will get even higher on profile because it will raise the nose to reduce the speed, and that will make the vertical speed less, so you got even higher on profile. We also have a little bit of tailwind, and the weight is quite high, it's 64.7 tons. So Now, this aircraft has a 66-ton landing weight, so that's not a problem, but we are getting higher and higher on profile here. Now, the speed brake is selected. Good. So the first officer is aware that he's high. And so, good. So at least that helps a little bit. Now, we are not cleared for the approach yet. You can see already we're above the glide slope. Is the glide slope valid? Maybe yes, maybe no. We are, because we are not on the localizer, but it's a clue, I guess. You can't rely on it too much, but what you can rely on is just do your profile calculation. Now, you can't see on the FMS now how what the distance is, but you can see it on the ILS DME. So let's take 20 miles. Let me see if that's exact. Yeah, so 20 miles, so 20 times 3 is 6,000 feet. We're doing S speed, so we can fly 500 feet lower. So we should be at 5,500 feet. Now, so you can see we're definitely above profile there. Now there's a little bit more track miles because we are doing a slight curve here, but it's not much. So this will be pretty accurate. Okay. Now let's see what happens next. So if I skip ahead a little bit, speed brake is still selected. And you can see that the aircraft will just stay kind of parallel. This flies parallel to the glide slope. So even the speed brake is not doing anything. Okay, so now flap 2 is selected. But there's a few things going wrong now. Well, first of all, if you select flap 2 and not do anything about it, then the aircraft will balloon. Usually if you select speed brake, that will balloon less. So the speed brake is selected now, so let's have a look how much it will balloon. But the biggest problem now is that the speed is still managed, and that will put the speed back lower, and the aircraft will just raise the nose to reduce the speed, and that will make the vertical speed lower, and then we get even higher on profile, and definitely with this tailwind here. So okay, speed brake selected. Let's see if it still balloons. Yeah, even with the speed brake, it balloons quite a bit, 400 feet a minute. It's a little bit less unusual, but still. And you can see that the speed starts to reduce because the speed is managed here. Speed bug is very low, much lower than the current speed. And we get a low vertical speed, and we're getting higher and higher and higher above the glide slope. Now, again, we're not cleared for the approach yet. Oh, we just cleared for the approach right there. So now, okay, but we're not on the localizer yet, so we cannot yet do a glide slope capture from above procedure. Okay, not to worry, you can still set a higher vertical speed, either by open send speed up or vertical speed bug down. Now it's a bit hard to see, but the gear is just being selected down. And let's see if that helps. So we still with flap 2, the speed managed, it's gonna reduce the speed. And even with the gear down, we still have a vertical speed, which is not that much. Now we're reaching our target speed, and now the vertical speed start to increase a bit more. Okay, so now because we just went into Logstar, we can do the, if we actually we are on one dot on the localizer, we can do the glide slope capture from above procedure. Okay, so how to do that? You set the air altitude higher than your current altitude and select the vertical speed at least 1500 feet a minute down, maximum 2000 feet a minute down. So now that's done correctly, and we're starting to slowly going back to the glide slope. Now, the first officer sets 1500 feet a minute here. I wouldn't do that. It's not enough. You're almost full deflection glide slope, and now you should really increase to 2000, which is just done here. So that's correct. Okay, so we got the gear down, we got flap 2. And the speed still starts to run away here. You see, we have a tailwind. So that's something to watch out for. Now, the speed brake is just being selected. Now, this is one thing to watch out for later for the landing checklist, because if the spoilers were armed before, and now you're going to use a speed brake, you will actually disarm that because we just lowered the gear. But okay. So now the vertical speed is 2,000 feet a minute. Speed brake, gear down, flap 2. VLS increases a little bit, not too much, but we are definitely catching up with the glide slope. And if I just skip ahead a little bit more, then there's glide slope star, and now we can start to configure flap 3 and flap 4. So let me see here. Okay, that's almost the end of the video. I don't think I have that here, but we'll definitely be stable with this configuration here. So yeah, everything went well in the end. I hope you learned something, and thank you for watching. If you like this video, please consider buying my book, Practical Descent Energy Management. It contains loads of examples of how to manage a descent and approach, and it is the only book available on this subject. There is a paperback and an ebook version available. You can find a link in the description below.